Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today's tutorial is about how to design an analysis of circular microstructure antenna using CST. For simulation, we are going to use CST Studio 2. So here you this is CST. Now create project. Okay, create a new template and we choose microwave, RF and optical. Then we choose antenna, press next. Then we choose planar, patch, slot, press next. Then we choose time domain, press next. And this is the units. Dimensions in millimeter, frequency in gigahertz, time in nanoseconds. Check all units, then press next. Okay, minimum frequency is 0 gigahertz and maximum frequency is 9 gigahertz. B field, H field, far field, power force, power loss, and press next. This is the summary of the template. Finish. Now we are going to modeling. Then first we set the view, reset view, and select view perspective font. Okay, then uncheck boundary box and this is the local WCS. Now modeling to bricks, press A, press escape. So this is the ground plane. So we set U minimum as minus 12.5 millimeter, U maximum is 12.5, V maximum is 12.5, minus 12.5, and V maximum is 12.5 millimeters. W minimum is 0 and W maximum is 0.036, the thickness of the copper. And material we select PEC, perfect electrical conductor. Preview, press OK. So this is our ground plane. Now we insert the substrate for modeling to bricks, press escape, and substrate U minimum is minus 12.5, U maximum is 12.5, V max minimum is 12.5, V maximum is 12.5, and V minimum is 0.036, and V maximum is 1.036. So substrate thickness we put is 0.036, and for material we select load material from main material library. So use filter and choose FR4 losing material, load, press load, preview, press OK. So this is the substrate you can see. Now before inserting patch over substrate, we shift WCS. So press transfer WCS at W axis. So we transport is 1.036. Preview, apply, OK. So will shift the WCS now for inserting the patch, server patch, modeling to cylinder. So outer radius of the cell, we said the outer radius of the cylinder is 6.96 millimeter, and W minimum is 0 and W maximum is 0.036. thickness of the copper and slag material is perfect electrical material. Preview, press OK. So we insert the circular patch. Now we insert the feed. For feed, we hear the U maximum is 0. Minus 0.5, and U maximum is 0.5. V minimum is 0 and V minimum is minus 12.5, V maximum is 0 and W maximum is minimum 0, W maximum is 0.036, and material we choose, the material is perfect electrical material, and this is the copper thickness. Preview, that's okay. So this is our feed, and now go component to select this patch, circular patch, and here we add and then select the feed and press enter. So this is boolean function we do, and add the feed. So you can see the circular patch antenna is ready for use. Now we create a waveguide port. So we are creating the waveguide port. First we will zoom in the area here, and so pick face, we select the pick face and this pick face, and for calculate the port extension coefficient, home to macros to solver ports, post calculate port extension coefficient, and this is the calculate, and the k is equal to in between the range of 4.35 to 7.22. So close, and we set k is equal to 5 and h is equal to 1. So for waveguide port, press on waveguide port. So x minimum is k star h, and x maximum is k star h, z minimum is k star h, and z maximum is h. So preview, that's okay. This is the view. You can see here the view, and this is the port. You can see this is the port and this is the ground. This is the port, and now we set the field monitor frequencies for far field. Firstly, we design 2.25, apply, we 4.5. okay, this is already 4.5 and 6.75. apply and press OK. So check the boundaries here. Open boundaries. Okay. You can see this is the boundaries. Okay. Frequency set 0 to 9. Okay. So now home to start simulation. So CST Studio Suite is calculating result for us. So the solver finished successfully. Now we can use the result for far-field result. This is the far-field 3D pattern. Okay. Now we can see theta angle. So the gain 2.25 gigahertz, 4.5 gigahertz, and 6.5 gigahertz, and 9 gigahertz. So here show structure and part will transparent. So you can see the structure. Printing and result 6.75, 4.5 and 2.25 gigahertz. So if you like this tutorial and please subscribe my YouTube channel and also like my Facebook page and follow on my Twitter. If you want some more tutorial, and please like, subscribe and share my video. Thank you very much.